Okay, hello back to the course of Introduction to Algorithms, and this is week 8. Today we'll talk about the binary search. So let's get started. So binary search is a search algorithm that finds the position of the target value within a sorted data type. And so binary search takes the middle value takes the middle element of the array or any other linear data structure, but in most cases it's array. If the middle value is not equal to the target value, then we like the half in which the target doesn't lie is eliminated, and search continues on the remaining half. On that half we again take the middle element, and we compare that middle element with the target value, and we repeat doing that until we find our target value. If the search ends with the remaining half being empty, then target is not in the array. So in a short, binary search works on a, as I said before, sorted data type. So this is very important, and it recursively or iteratively compares the middle element, and if the target is bigger than the middle element, then it goes to the right side. If the target is less than the middle, it goes to the left side. So here is the process. During the binary search, there can be three cases. So first case is that if the target value is equal to the middle element, then we return the position. If the target value is smaller, then continue to search on the left side. If the target value is larger, then it continues search to on the right side. And as you can see, the time complexity is big O of log M time. So if you have the array with the size of the N, then you can find your target elements in a logarithmic time complexity, which is very efficient. So here is the binary search step by step. Let's say that we have this kind of array, and as you can see, this is sorted, and we need to find 12 in this array. So here, as you can see, we have 9 elements. Okay, and so what does the binary search do? We take the middle of the array, which is a 50, and we compare the 50 with our target element. And as you can see, the middle element in our target, they are not equal. So, and we see that the target is less than the middle. Then we start to look for on the left side. On the left side, again we take the middle element, and the middle element is equal to the to our target element, so it means that we have found our target element. So both are matching, and so result element found an index 1, and the index 1 is this. This is the first example. But let's say that we want to find 80. Again, we have the same array, and the array is sorted, which is very important, and we start to take the middle element. So middle is this one, right? So we compare 50 and 80. 50 and 80, they are not equal. So and we see that the target element is bigger than our middle element, then we throw away this left side, including the middle, and we start to look for the middle element on the right side. So on the right side we take the middle again, which is 65, and again we compare that they are not equal, right? So we throw away, so we don't consider anymore this part of the array, and we start to look for in this part. In this part, the middle element is 80, because we like add 7 plus 8, which is equal to the 15, Then we divide by 2, it's 7.5, but it's integer, that's why we take the just integer side of the division. So we compare the middle element, which is 80, with our target, and we see that they're equal. So we return the index of the element, which is equal to the 7. Here is the pseudocode of the binary search, as you can see. And initially we have some target, right? Then we have some like our starting point, then right, and we like, and this is our array and our target element x. If initially we say that L low is equal to our P, so then high we say that it's a max of the P R plus 1. Then we launch run our while loop and we say that while low is less than the high, then we take the middle element, and if the middle element, so we find here the index of the middle element. Here we compare our target with middle. If the middle is less or equal to the mid, then we say the high is equal to the mid, or we say that low is equal to mid plus 1, and in the end we just return high. Also here you may see that on each step we need to find the middle element, and the middle element is in order to find it, we need to add low, so left side plus high, which is the right side, and divide it by 2, right? But there can be some issue with that. If we do like left plus r divided by 2, it may lead to the integer overflow. Of course, the implementation of the binary search can be very easy. It may look like easy, but there is some tricky points, like this one. This, if you use in your code this one, it may lead to the integer overflow. In order to avoid the integer overflow, you need to find the middle point in a different way. So, as you know, for example, integer int data type has a range between this value and this value. And let's say that you are equal to this value, so to the last value on a range of the integer, to this one. And if, for example, L equal to the 1, then in that case there can be integer overflow. That's why in order to avoid that, we need to find the midpoint using this code. So it's L plus R minus L divided by 2. And if you use this problem, if you use this code, you will avoid the integer overflow. Of course, you can use, for example, long or any other data types that can store even bigger range. But let's say that you can, if you take the long, long has also range, right? And there is like a possibility that R will be equal to the range of that long. So this code can be applied to any data types. So there won't be any overflow like long or any even bigger data type with bigger range. So next, we will talk about the binary search in terms of the, finding a solution to the problem. So let's say that we have a sorted array is like this and target. We need to find the index if the target is found. If not, we need to return the index where it would be if it were inserted in order. So for example here, the target exists in our array, and that's why we return 2, right? Here, the same array, and again it's sorted, but the target is equal to the 2. So, but here, as you can see in this code, in this array, the 2 doesn't exist, so we just need to return 1 here. Because if it would be in this array, it should be like located in this position, like on index 1. Here, as you can see, 7 doesn't exist, and if it would be there, it would be at position 4. So it would be here, and that's why we return 4. So the algorithm to find this, to solve this problem is obvious. Of course, it's binary search, but here is one tricky moment that it should return the index. Like if the target doesn't exist in array, it should return some index where it would be. So of course, first one we can apply the brute force. Brute force means we just do linear check on the array and find position of the target element. It means that we just go from left to right and find the element. And in that case, the time complexity would be O of n. But like even though it is O of n, it's not efficient. Efficient is a big O of log n. And here we can apply the binary search. So if the target is found, then return the position of the element. If the target is not found, then return the left range of the binary search. So in the end, left range would be like located at a place where the target element would be located, even though it doesn't exist. It doesn't located on that array. And the time complexity is big O of log n. Next, you need to find square root. So write a function which returns the square of root x without using any built-in methods or libraries. X is guaranteed to be a non-negative integer. So for example, input 4, output 2. So so you need to find square root without using any built-in methods. Of course, first of all, first approach is a brute force. Try all possible numbers between 1 and x. We take every number and take its square. If it is equal to x, then we find our square root. So in that case, the time complexity would be O of x, right? Because we try every possible solution and we go until that x number. And it's again linear time complexity. So, but here we can apply the binary search, and if we apply the binary search, the time complexity, of course, would be less. So again, if you look at the problem, take a couple minutes, think about how would you solve this problem, press pause, and then like try to solve this problem, then press play, then compare your solution with the solution on the lecture. So how would the brute force look like? For example, it would like from I to x, and if I multiplied by I is equal to x, then return I, then we increase. How can we optimize the solution? We can of course optimize the solution. We don't need to go to till the x. All the integers square root is less or equal to the half of the x, so we can like just go just on the half of the x, but anyways it's it can be linear time complexity, because as you remember, if we just take the half, right, like this, we here ignore the constant, and anyways it's equal to big O of x. So here we just write x divided by 2 instead of the just x. Okay, Of course, second approach is binary search. So we know that the x is a positive, and we know the square root cannot be less than 1, and we can make binary search between 1 and x. So we take the middle between 1 and x, and if middle multiplied by middle is equal to x, then we found our square root. If middle multiplied by middle is bigger than x, then we do binary search on the left subarray. If middle multiplied by middle less than the x, then we do binary search on the right subarray. Of course, here we don't have subarray, we just have some numbers. And why we can apply binary search to this problem? Because first of all, as we said before, that x is a positive number, right? So it's positive number, it means that square root is located between 0 and x, right? And everything between 0 and x is sorted. So so our solution is located between this, like between 0 and x, and also it satisfies second requirement for the binary search, like we know the range of the of our solution. We know that left is 0, right, and right is x, and our solution is between these two ranges, and between those two they are like everything is sorted. That's why we can apply the binary search. Again guys, for future problems, if you have some problem and this like answer is located between some range and this range is sorted, it means that you can apply a binary search to find the solution. So here, what do we do? For example, if x is equal to the 4, we know that it is between, not including 0 of course, it's in between 1 and 4, the solution. So we take middle, so which is we add up 1 plus 4 is equal to the 5, we divide by 2, it's 2.5, but it's integer, and we take the integer part, which is a 2, then we multiply 2 by 2, and we see that the square of the 2 is equal to 4, so we, this is how we find the solution. If it wouldn't be, if the square is, it would be bigger than 4, we would search on the left side. If the square of the middle is less than, we would look for on the right side. Next problem, it's finding minimum in a rotated sorted array. Suppose an array sorted in ascending order, and it's rotated at some pivot unknown to you beforehand. So array doesn't have any duplicates. So let's say that we had some array like this, which can just consist of these numbers, and after some rotation, the our array became like this. So the first three numbers stay on the last three positions, and we need to find the minimum element. So of course, as you can see, this in this task, if the array would be the sorted, we would easily apply the binary search. Even maybe we wouldn't use binary search because it's rotated, right? We would just take the first element. But here, this array is kind of partially sorted. That's why it has some tricky points about using applying the binary search. So first of all, of course, it's using the brute force. If we use brute force, we would just check out every possible element in our array, right? But in that case, the time complexity would be big O of n, and n is the size of the number of elements in the array. But actually, this is not efficient algorithm, right? Efficient, we know that it can be found in a logarithm time complexity. So how can we apply binary search to this array? So as you can see, if we would have just simple sorted array, we would know that the element on the right side is bigger than on that element on the left side. I mean, the last element is would be bigger than the first element because we have no rotation, right? But in a rotated array, as you can see, the last element is like it's not bigger, it's less than the first element. So by using this characteristic of the sorted of rotated array, we can apply our binary search. So how can we apply? So in a rotated sorted array, the first parts would be in increasing order. So it would increase element after the element, right? But at some point, it would change from the increasing to decrease. So like next element would be less than the left element. And again, after this point, it would again increase. So this is called infection point. So in order to find the minimum element, we know that the minimum element is located after the biggest element. It's located around the infection point. And if the left element is bigger than the right element, then we can say that the right element is our minimum element in the array. So so how we apply the binary search? If mid element is bigger than the first element, that means that we need to look for the infection point on right mid, right? If mid element is less than the first element of array, then we need to look for the infection point on left mid. So what do we do? So we have range, initial range, left is here, located here, right located here, and we take the mid element, which is this one, and we compare the mid with the left element, and we see that left element is less than the right element. It means that our minimum element located in this part of the array, so we don't consider anymore this part, right? Then when we consider this part, we again, so we moved our left to this position and the right stays here, and the mid is this one, and we compare the mid with the left, and we see that left is bigger than the mid. And we also compare the left previous element with the next element, and we see that next element is less than left element. In this case, we can say that our minimum is located here. This is how we find the solution. On next, next task, we have we need to again sort the array in ascending order, and again it's rotated at some pivot element unknown to you beforehand, so we don't know where our pivot, like where is our infection point, right? So we need to find the target value in logarithm time complexity. So the function should return the position of the value. So we need to return index of the target value in the array. Here is example. We have this kind of rotated sorted array, and we have target equal to the 1, and we need to output 3 because it's 0, 1, 2, and 3, and here locate our target element. So how can we do binary search in this array? If we can we? Of course, we can use binary search in this array, but the most important part, the tricky part, is that applying this binary search. It's actually a very like similar problem to the previous, except with that we need to find the target. We don't need to find the minimum element. So, so how do we apply binary search into this array? So, for example, let's say that we have this array and we need to find 16. So we first find the pivot element, like element where we have the infection point. And we divide the array into two subarrays, right? Here, then we call the binary search for one of the two subarrays. If element is greater than smallest element, then search in the left array. Else, search in the right array. If element is not is found in selected subarray, then return the index. Or if we don't find, we just return minus one. Next task, we need to find the first and last position of element in sorted array. So let's say that we have array of integers and it's sorted in ascending order. We need to find the starting and ending position of a given target value. For example, we have this kind of array and we have target 8. We need to find the first occurrence and last occurrence of the 8. Of course, we can apply the brute force. So brute force means that we do linear search by looking to every element. In this case, the time complexity is big O of n. Second approach, of course, we can find the element by doing binary search. When we find the element, so first we just do apply the simple binary search, and the simple binary search helps to find the element, right? Then after finding the element, we again do binary search on the left side from that element and to find the first position. And we do the binary search on the right side from the element to find the last position of element. If for the left side, if nums like target is not equal to middle minus one, then it means that we have found our first element. If for the right side, if the target if the target not equal to nums to the middle plus one position, then we found our last position. So this is how we do. On the next task, we need to find element in two-dimensional matrix. So we have sorted matrix, so it's two-dimensional array, and we need to find the element from the matrix. So matrix has next characteristics. Integers in each row are sorted from left to right, and the first integer of each row is greater than the last integer of the previous row. So here, example, as you can see, this is a two-dimensional array. So, and as you can see that each elements are sorted from left to right, right? And the first integer of each row, so this is bigger than the last integer of the previous row. So the 10 is bigger than 7, 23 is bigger than 20, and the target is equal to 10. And so output is this position because it's the first row, as you can see, and the zero column. So how do we apply the binary search? Of course, we can apply the binary search, a brute force. We check elements by element if it equals to the target element and return the position of the element, right? In this case, the time complexity would be big O of n, where n is the number of elements. We can do the binary search, but we need to treat this matrix as a simple ordered array and do binary search on this matrix. In a summary, in short, I want to say that binary search is a very efficient algorithm. Efficient because it's, if you see in terms of the time complexity, it's around in log of big O of log n. but because it's efficient, it should, in order to apply the binary search, you should satisfy next conditions, like first one, it should be the solution should be like sorted, right? Or our input should be sorted. And second, we need to know the range where our solution is located. If we know the range and if the like our possible solution is sorted, then we can apply the binary search. And also to find the midpoint, it's better to use this, because if you just use like L plus R divided by 2, in this case it may lead to the overflow, like integer overflow, or if you use even bigger, like long overflow. So that's it. Thank you very much for your attention. Thank you. Bye.